Welcome to Ghana. We're not here, but we're going to talk about it. Drums, singing, and dancing in contrast from what I know, what we know. So there's a lot of different musical genres in Ghana, just like we have in America or anywhere else in the world. But for the sake of this presentation, we are talking specifically about traditional Ghanaian music. Ghana originated as an empire in 300 AD. The Soninke people used the word Ghana to refer to the king as Warrior King, and eventually they just resorted to referring to the whole region as Ghana. Through the years, their people have been enslaved and colonized many times. This made it very difficult to maintain the traditions involved with their culture. What do most people already know about music in Ghana? There are a lot of misconceptions about Ghanaian culture in the Western world. A lot of people think that it's just drumming, or that it's less advanced than our music, or that it's chaotic and weird. But really, there's a lot of drumming, but they don't view it as drumming, and there's more to it than just that. Our music is not better or more advanced in any way, we just do things differently. And while it may seem odd to our culture's standards to them, it's not, it's just music to them. Traditional Ghanaian music is also enjoyed differently. When we see a group of people perform music, we usually just sit back and enjoy. Depending on the group, sometimes it's normal to dance a little bit or sing along when it's not necessarily expected. In Ghana, music is a celebration, and everyone's a part of it. The point isn't to go watch people perform, it's more like a big party. Everyone who attends a Ghanaian musical event is up and dancing and singing all together. It's like a social event. Why is it another world? Because there are so many differences between the way we do music and the way they do it. It's mostly in a foreign language. Not every song, but a lot of it is religious, about religions that very few Americans know about or practice. And they use instruments that would be very uncommon in American culture, such as Panlogo drums, just one of the big assortment of drums that they would use in this music, made in Ghana. A Gankogwe bell, also made in Ghana, has a higher pitch than a lower pitched bell. And an Ahache from West Africa. They maybe wouldn't necessarily use this one, but any kind of shaker like that. A little more in depth on the differences. Traditional Ghanaian music does not follow a clear-cut meter like Western music does, but I'll talk more about that later. They follow a bell pattern, which you will also hear in some examples later on. They use a different hand drumming technique. Everyone follows a master drummer. There's lots of call and response singing, so someone sings one thing, then everyone sings it back. And songs use 5 or 7 notes in contrast to our 12, which is very interesting. So, for some examples on polyrhythmic meter, first we're going to listen to some very, what we would hear as normal things. We're going to start with everyone's favorite, Taylor Swift. Press play here. You can very clearly hear. This is the tempo, right here, this is it. There's no debating that. That is how the song feels, that's where it is. That's the same way that everyone is going to feel it. And we see this the same way in a newer song. I skip forward to the right part here. To the right part. Right here. You can very clearly hear. This is it. This is how everyone's feeling the song. If you're dancing to it, that's the beat. There is no question. Now, this one, we're going to listen to Panlogo, a traditional Ghanaian song. It's going to be... I feel like a lot of people would probably agree on a feel for this song, but it's not necessarily a required thing to feel it that way. We hear the bell pattern. This is what was mentioned earlier. And it's going to slowly build up into some more things. To slowly add on more and more. And you see, there is no clear defined beat. And as we add more layers and more layers, it just gets more confusing, I guess. Vocals. We're just kind of feeling it. I think we get the idea on that. Now, if we pull up Fume Fume, it's going to move a little quicker, and be a little bit more confusing. So hold on to this one. So if you were trying to meter this out, you're already lost. More layers and more layers. No one listening to the same thing. So that's how the polyrhythmic meter works. That's not what was meant to happen. That's not good. Which one's the refresh button? There it is.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. There we go. That's not good.
Go over to the other tab. And then click on turn in.
There's like a big...
What do you present?
There's a little down arrow if you go left just a little bit.
Here?
Too far. Over some...
Here.
Yeah. And then it says...
There we go. Yeah. All right. What the heck? Why do we not like the space bar?
Oh, yeah.
That was polyrhythmic meter. Now, how do these groups work? A Ghanaian drum and dance group consists of drums and shakers and bells, led by a master drummer and dancers, all of whom sing. The master drummer initiates several different calls to coordinate changes in the music. Sometimes they will sing a verse, and everyone else involved with the music will sing it back, like call and response, like I mentioned before. Other times, they will play something on their drums to signify a change in the music, often to communicate with the dancers. The songs work in a sort of circular pattern. They go on in an infinite loop, with changes made to each iteration. Obviously, they eventually stop. And that's Ghana.